So, I was thinking, how to write this monologue? No, really. I've written essays and journal entries and speeches and blogs and emails and scripts and short stories. Damn. I even wrote 3 status updates before coming to class. But not a monologue. And I can't just write any monologue. I have to be funny. I have to be original. I have to be creative. And I can't just be talking about my identity, like straightforward. Because damn well, I know pretty sure everyone's going to be talking about their identity. Or apple pie. So, how do I write this monologue? Okay, well, yeah, sure. I can always start with talking about my identity. And if I come up with something better, I can always go with something like that, right? And, okay, and I can always do the angry monologue. People do angry monologues all the time. That's easy. All they do is be angry and mad. How hard is that? What? Who do you say that I'm not Filipino enough? Just because I wasn't born in the Philippines just like you? Just because I can't speak Tagalog as fluently like you? Just because I don't follow all the customs like you? Psh. I'm more Filipino than you are. I know more our culture than you are. I know more than our history than you. I go to church every Sunday like a Filipino. I pray the rosary like a Filipino. I write my Bible script like a Filipino. I can sing, fight, dance like a Filipino. Bitch, whoa. Maybe I don't want to do an angry monologue. That's kind of too intense. I don't want people to think that I'm an angry person, because I'm not. Okay, well, I can keep the content eased up a bit and change up the tone, make it more lighthearted and be something going on the lines of, what do you know about being Filipino? Because even though I'm born in Canada and raised in California, I am born of 2 Filipino parents. My father was born in Cebu City and my mother was born in Quezon City, and that makes me a pure blood Filipino, and I am damn proud of it, and this making it sound like a spoken word than a monologue. Damn, this is harder than I thought. You can't do angry or else it would be too intense, or if I change it up too much then it's becoming a spoken word piece. And now I'm back to square one. So, how do I write this monologue? The funny thing is, when I was watching this Grammy Awards Sunday night, I was watching Taylor Swift win all awards, like Album of the Year, and I was inspired how she was doing a monologue on Saturday Night Live, how she sang her monologue, and I thought it was kind of cool. And then, on top of me rehearsing in front of the mirror in my bathroom, trying to figure out what monologues I wanted to do for this class, and then me conversating with myself, and me debating with myself what monologues I want to do, I realized by talking to myself, me debating myself, as well as me talking here right now, that this is actually mine. La la, la 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 la, this is my Asian M monologue.